Okay. Show me.
Hi there, guys. Welcome back to the Dusty Sea Channel. Thank you very much for tuning in. For my FPV maiden, I guess. Not technically. I've done one FPV flight with this Gap RC Mark IV 6S RTF Binanfly 2020 edition. Yeah, okay, so in my maiden flight it was far too windy. You wouldn't be able to hear what I said. And also, ordinarily I'd say wind doesn't really matter all that much on a 5-inch quadcopter. This time, however, there was so much wind it did definitely matter. So, maiden FPV flight with the Gap RC Mark IV. We're gonna see if it flies well. I haven't tuned it at all. It's bone stock, is it? I've added a little bit of expo. Let me see, 20 on all axes. Maybe if you are a less experienced pilot, I'd say a little more expo, like 35 on all axes. But yeah, just to shave off the edges, so to say, I've added 20% stock. There was no expo, and especially if you want to capture nice videos with a quadcopter like this, I'd say add a little bit of expo. So yeah, I'm gonna do two flights actually, and I'm gonna be using these lipos, CNHL Black Series 1100 milliamp hour 6S. I've been testing these for a couple of months. I'm very pleased with these lipos. They perform well. So I have like 10 of these, so I'm doing a longer term review of them coming up in maybe a month or so. Let's do some flying. There we go, maiden FPV flight with the Gap RC Mark IV. Oh, and the first thing I noticed is that the call sign says 4S. What? Yeah, okay, so I guess they use the same call sign for all their Mark IVs, and there is indeed also a 4S version. So the second thing you will notice is that the weather isn't super duper. We have ourselves a nice dramatic looking sky here. Looks like a painting actually. Gorgeous. Yeah, okay, so it's not sunny. However, the temperature is actually pretty nice. Also, you have probably never seen this location. Yeah, I am kind of in the middle of nowhere here. All my usual flying spots were occupied by peoples. Peoples? What the hell? So this flying spot we have here isn't all that exciting probably. There aren't obstacles to speak of. But we do have a lot of room. There's nobody around. So it's nice and safe. And we've got some water over there. Actually, that little lake over there is where I learned how to windsurf. Over there. It does look completely different from when I... That's like 200 years ago, as you can imagine. Yeah, in the heydays of windsurfing, that was. Actually, when Robbie Nash won his first, I think Robbie Nash had just won his first world championship, maybe a little sooner. Okay, let's talk about this quadrocopter. I think that the reception... Oh, and by the way, on my goggle I have a new aerial, a new antenna from Rush FPV. It's a little shorter than the Lumiere one I used before. So it's a 90 degree mount cherry. Brand new, actually. And I'm also testing that, and as you can hopefully see, my reception is super duper actually. Now it should have been super duper.
3 minutes.
But I am now flying, let's see, dead behind myself. So I'm definitely only using the Cherry. Very nice reception. I haven't checked whether this antenna pokes above my head. You can see if all is well. If you're not blocked. Hey, RSSI low. RSSI low. I can actually extend the antenna on the quadcopter a little further out. The way I've mounted them now is kind of like safety for crashes. But I was pretty far out. It's not super duper surprising. Okay, so I am not all that familiar with this location. I definitely don't know which holes I can and can't poke through. And there are water hazards all over the place. Can I fly through these? Yeah. Oh, that's a nice. I do know that you see this path over here, right? There are often people here, but this does look like a nice gap to take at speed. Yeah. Oh well. Yeah, the FPV feed looks very clean. You have probably noticed. And obviously, I'm using this here first flight to check if everything actually works. So yeah, RSSI low.
5 minutes.
RSSI low. And that was dead behind me. So I guess my enormous muscular body was blocking my radio signal as well. And I have the antenna sideways. So, okay. Yeah, and I was at that farm there over. So, not bad. That's nothing to be concerned about. If we'd hear RSSI low now, that would be a fault. My quadcopter has the RXSR receiver, in case you are wondering. Okay, so we are. Oh, the OSD is a little different. Yeah, I am flying it bone stock. I will rearrange the OSD a little for my further flights, but actually, it looks almost like I'd run it, but I'd have an amp meter on my bottom left and air mode in the top right corner. What for? It's not as if you'd be flying this quadcopter in auto level mode. Okay, so, but 6 minutes is very much respectable. 21 volts, 6 minutes. Yeah, the quadcopter doesn't have an action cam on it. In further videos, I will test that. I'll be mounting a GoPro Session 8. So basically there, it's heaviest action camera from GoPro. And we'll see how well the quadcopter performs then. Today, I'm testing the quadcopter bone stock. Okay, so now that we know the quadcopter actually flies, let's do a second battery and see what it's made of. Here we go. All right, there we go again. I must say, the quadcopter definitely feels powerful. As it should, of course. It's 2020 and we are flying 6S. But usually I fly my own quadcopters with like 2207 or 2207 and a half or maybe even 2208 motors. And the Mark II and this Mark IV have a different philosophy, I guess. 2306 and a half motors for this Mark IV. And is that all that different? It is different. Probably the end result will be mostly the same amount of power. However, I can definitely sense that the bulk of the power is down low in the first two-thirds, so the first 60% of your throttle stick range. It flies a little different, basically. So, and in the last, yeah, there's, well, actually it's still pretty fast in the last one-third. Yeah, these motors, I guess, work out. I don't know, I haven't checked if these motors are separately available. I expect they are, if only for replacement purposes. But if these motors have a reasonable price to them, like 15, 14 euros, these might be an option. They perform. They definitely make this Mark IV a feisty quadcopter.
2 minutes.
Better than, well, basically what I was hoping. It's almost addictive, actually. Yeah. Yeah, punches. It's hard for you, probably, or also for me, by the way, to judge from the FPV feed how fast things actually move, but this isn't my first rodeo. I know that these punch-outs are pretty significant. Also, the quadcopter has a nice sound to it. And that's, yeah, that is mostly due to the propellers, I know. Nice bonus, I guess. Also, from my line of sight flying with this quadcopter, I noticed that it flies very precise, in the sense of you being able to fly it, for instance, very low to the ground precisely. The throttle response is, yeah, probably because most of the bite is down low, it instantly responds to your throttle inputs. I hope that makes sense, but it's easy to fly it low, like so. Yeah, and again, the FV feed is nice and clean. Only when I apply a lot of throttle, like so, I see some lines. Maybe in the DVR recording you are now watching there, it's more significant. To me, I can see it, barely noticeable though. Definitely not something I'd care about at all. You know what, I will probably need to fly this quadcopter on some other propellers as well. Not that these seem horrible, but simply to see how the quadcopter flies on propellers that I know. So far, the entire package is pretty impressive. Yeah, and if you've seen my first video on this quadcopter, definitely a fail on the assembly. But that I don't like doing negative videos. So that makes me happy. I also paid for this quadcopter, I didn't get it for free. So that also makes me happy that it actually flies well. If you are familiar with my channel, I usually sell, not all, but sell the RCs I review. So if it wouldn't have performed well or was faulty, I wouldn't have sold it at all. So in that case, it would have been 100% loss to me. But again, I definitely don't enjoy doing negative videos, so I'm happy the quadcopter flies well. Okay, we are 5.5 minutes in, and we are still above 21 volts. Pretty nice. Pretty nice. Yeah, pretty nice. I am impressed with this quadcopter. It flies nicely. Okay, so in the next video on this quadcopter, there will be a GoPro Hero 8 on it. Today, however, that GoPro Hero 8 is over there. Yeah. maybe I'll buy me a second one for our videos like this, but those are expensive cameras, as you probably know. Yeah, so again, you might think watching YouTube reviews that YouTube reviewers are overly positive to maybe sell you things. Some probably are. Some, like me at least, I definitely don't like doing it. It doesn't feel nice to do negative videos. Sometimes you have to, but again, I am happy that even after a rocky start with this quadcopter, if you haven't seen my first video, shame on you. The assembly of the stick wasn't correct. There was too much play in the entire stick and the quadcopter flew horribly. So with that rocky start, I'm now happy that the quadcopter actually performs very, very well. Better than expected. Well, it should perform well, right? Cap RC, reputable brand, and 6S, and so again, it should perform well. Also, yeah, the FPV setup. I flew this quadcopter today at 200 milliwatts, which is for this flight more than enough, right? So that worked out well. The camera, Caddx, should work, right? It isn't a sunny day, as you can tell. So this is slightly more of a test for the camera than a sunny day. We all know that these Caddx cameras actually work well, right? As long as they actually work. You know what I mean. Yeah, so okay, so that was my initial impressions of the FPV performance of the Cap RC Mark IV. Very nice, I enjoyed myself. I hope you liked the video as well or found it to be informative. If you are left with questions about this or anything else, oh, by the way, I flew the quadcopter with this, the Jumper T16 Pro. In case you are wondering and you saw which goggle I used, this is the SkyZone Sky O3 OLED. Marvelous. I love it. Yeah. Again, if you are left with questions, comment section down below. Catch you on the next video. Bye-bye.